examination. So let us start vitamin A. These are the objectives are to know. At the end of today's lecture, you should be able to understand chemistry of vitamin A, then sources and daily requirement of vitamin A, then absorption, transport, storage of vitamin A. Similarly, functions of vitamin A, deficiency manifestation of vitamin A, and lastly, toxicity of vitamin A. So first, chemistry of vitamin. So this vitamin A is a fat soluble vitamin. Last time I told you there are two type of vitamin. One is fat soluble and another is water soluble. So this vitamin A belongs to which class? Fat soluble. So vitamin A is a fat soluble vitamin. The active form of vitamin A is present in only animal tissue, okay? But pro-vitamin of vitamin A is beta-carotene, and this beta-carotene is present in plant tissue. Next is chemistry. There are different forms. There are four forms of vitamin A. First is retinol. This retinol is also known as vitamin A alcohol. Okay. Second type of form is retinal. Retinal means it is also called as vitamin A aldehyde. And third important form, that is retinoic acid. And this is also known as vitamin A acid. And last form, beta-carotene. Beta-carotene, it is a pro-vitamin A. What is mean by pro-vitamin? Pro-vitamin is a vitamin which is converted into vitamin in our body. So it is a precursor form of vitamin, that is beta-carotene. So out of these four, first retinal and retinoic acid, they are known as carotenoids. And these four, retinal, retinoic acid, beta carotene, these are collectively known as vitamin A. So this is four different forms. So one by one we are going to discuss here. First, retinol. So retinol, it is a primary alcohol. It contains beta ionic ring. See, this ring is known as beta ionic ring, and this ring is also known as trimethyl cyclohexylene ring. And this chain is known as isoprenoid chain, and this functional group is here, that is CH2OH. So it is a alcohol. So it is a primary alcohol containing beta ionon ring. This ring is also known as trimethyl cyclohexylene ring, and this chain, it is an isoprenoid chain, and it contains four double bonds. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are four double bonds. So this is a retinol. Next is retinol. It is also known as vitamin A aldehyde. Can you hear me? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this retinal, this is an aldehyde form because CHO group is there. See this terminal group, first terminal function group, it is a CHO, and this is a aldehyde. So that's why this is an aldehyde form, and this is obtained by the oxidation of retinal, and remaining things are same. It contains this ring and this isoprenoid chain with four double bonds. So this is about retinol. Next is retinoic acid. This is produced by oxidation of retinol. Okay, retinoic acid, it is produced by the oxidation of retinol. Retinol, retinoic acid, and beta carotene. So out of this is a retinoic acid. Next is beta carotene, and it is also known as pro vitamin A. Okay. Now this pro vitamin A or beta carotene, it is found only in plant foods. It is not found in animal foods. Okay. So it contains a 40 carbon compound, and it does not contain a terminal functional group. And it has 2 beta ionon ring. Can you see the structure of this beta carotene? To the bottom. Yes. Hello.
Sir.
Okay. Now this beta carotene, it is divided in small intestine into 2 molecules of retina. Molecules of retina by the enzyme dioxygenase. This is the name of enzyme dioxygenase, which is present in small intestine. And this beta carotene, initially I told you it is a provitamin. Provitamin means which is converted into vitamin. So in this way, this beta carotene is converted into 2 molecule of retina. See, this upper side, it is a beta carotene. This is enzyme dioxygenase, and this beta carotene is converted into 2 molecule of retina. So in this way, provitamin is converted into vitamin. Okay. So in MCQ, there is a always question about this dioxygenase. What is the name of enzyme which split beta carotene into 2 molecule of retina? The name of that enzyme is dioxygenase. Then sources. This is the chemistry of this vitamin A. Next point, sources. There are 2 type of sources. First is animal. Animal sources. Animal sources are those sources which is from animal origin, and it include fish liver oil is the richest source of vitamin A, that is cod liver oil and shark liver oil. Similarly, milk, butter, cream, cheese and liver of sheep, pig and goat are also excellent source of vitamin A. All these are derived from, all these are obtained from animal source, animal origin. That's why it is known as animal sources. Fish liver oil, that is cod liver oil, shark liver oil, milk, butter, cheese, cream, and liver of sheep, pig, and goat. And one more important source that is known as vitamin A2. Another name for this vitamin A2 is 3-dehydroretinol, and this is present only in fresh water fishes. Okay, so fish is very good for health. So instead of meat, red meat or chicken, you have to always eat fish because it gives vitamin A. So this is about animal sources. Next is vegetables sources or plant sources. Plant sources are those which is derived from, which is obtained from plant or vegetable, and it includes carrot. Carrot is a, it contains significant quantity of beta carotene, and similarly colored fruits, that is papaya, mango, orange, banana, pumpkins, jackfruit, tomatoes, drumstick, sweet potato, and also green leafy vegetables, that is spinach, fenugreek, amarnath. Amarnath, it is a type of green leafy vegetable. And the most important source of vitamin A is carrot. And that's why 1 carrot a day will keep ophthalmologist away. So remember this thing. If you are suffering from any eye this is, so you have to eat one carrot a day. One carrot a day will keep Allah's army. So next is daily requirement. Recommended daily allowance of vitamin A. So this is for infant, very less, 400 microgram per day. How much it is? 400. For children, slightly higher, 600 microgram per day. But for men and women, requirement is more. For men, 750 to 1000 microgram per day, and for women, 750 microgram per day. But for pregnant woman, requirement is more, and that is 1000 microgram per day. Okay, this is for pregnant woman, but lactating woman, requirement is more, and that is 1200 microgram per day. So this is in a microgram per day, but there is another unit is there, that is international unit per day. So for infant, 1500 international unit per day. For children, 2000 international unit per day. For adult, 5000 international unit per day. And for lactating woman, pregnant woman, requirement is more, and that is 6000 to 8000 international unit per day. Now here, one international unit is equal to 0.3 milligram of retinol, or 6 microgram of beta carotene. So this is about daily requirement. Next is absorption, where it is absorbed in our body, where it is stored, and how it transport. This retinol present in diet in retinal ester, in this form, in which form? Retinal ester, or this is also known as retinyl palmitate. Okay, so in small intestine it is absorbed, but before absorption this retinal ester is hydrolyzed to free retinol, and this retinal ester hydrolyzed, this enzyme is secreted from pancreas. So in this way, this retinol is present in a diet in the form of retinal ester or retinal palmitate, and in small intestine this retinal ester is hydrolyzed to free retinol, and this free retinol, then it is transported, then it is stored mainly in liver, and significant amount in other tissue like kidney, adrenal gland, lungs, retina. Storage form, initially I told you, retinyl palmitate. Then this retinol is transported in the blood in association with a specific retinal binding protein, that is RBP. Okay, in this way it is absorbed, transport and storage. Then the most important topic is most important point regarding this vitamin A is biochemical functions of vitamin A. So first important function is that vitamin A is required or essential for the normal and color vision. Okay, it is required for normal and color vision. So this role of vitamin A in vision, first time it is discovered by one scientist, and the name of that scientist is George Watt, and for this invention he received a Nobel Prize in 1968. So that's why this vitamin A is very much essential for the normal and color vision. The cyclic events found in the process of vision, is known as rhodopsin cycle or Walsh visual cycle. So this Walsh visual cycle is also known as rhodopsin cycle, and there is a always short note on this Walsh visual cycle, but at present I am not going to tell you in detail. Why? Because you people are going to learn this Walsh visual cycle in physiology. So at this moment you should be able to understand only the cyclic events found in the process of vision is known as rhodopsin cycle, or wall visual cycle. So this is the first most important functions of vitamin A. Next is, it is also required for the reproduction and growth. That is retinol. Retinol plays very important role in reproduction and growth. And next is, it is also required for differentiation. It is also required for differentiation. Vitamin A, it is also acts as a steroid hormone. So these are the most important functions. Next is, retinoic acid. It is also essential for the synthesis of glycoprotein or glucopolysaccharide. And next function is, it is also required for the regulation of gene expression. Vitamin A is also required for teeth and bone formation. And vitamin A is also useful in the treatment of acne and psoriasis. Psoriasis and acne, it is a skin diseases. And vitamin A is useful in the treatment of acne and psoriasis. Vitamin A also prevents chemical carcinogenesis. So this is again one more important function of vitamin A. Next is vitamin A, it maintains of nervous tissue, that is myelin sheath formation. And you know, high intake of beta carotene, it prevents heart attack, because beta carotene acts as an antioxidant. So that's why beta carotene, it is also useful for the prevention of heart attack. And carotenoids are present in leafy vegetables. So intake of these carotenoids or intake of this fresh vegetable, it reduces the incidence of cancer. So these are the most important functions of this vitamin A. So this is about functions. Next is deficiency manifestation. Deficiency manifestation of vitamin A. Deficiency manifests only if diet is without vitamin A for a period of 2 to 3 months. When hepatic store is depleted, whatever vitamin A is stored in liver, if it is depleted, if it is reduced, if it is less, then deficiency manifests. And the most deficiency manifestation is night blindness. Night blindness, it is also known as night alopecia. In simple word, night blindness is nothing but there is a inability to see in a dim light. Or you can say it is characterized by loss of vision in night, dim light or poor light. And that's why our dark adaptation time is increased. Next is xerophthalmia. Severe deficiency of vitamin A causes dryness of cornea and conjunctiva, and this clinical condition termed as xerophthalmia. Conjunctiva become dry, thick, and wrinkled, and conjunctiva gets keratinized and it loses its normal transparency. In certain areas of conjunctiva, white triangular plaques are seen. In certain areas of conjunctiva, white triangular plaques seen, and this plaques known as Bytot spot. See the upper slide. You know, see there is a white plaques are there. So this is known as Bytot spot, and this light, it is a keratomalacia. See, when xerophthalmia persists for a long time, it progresses to keratomalacia, and it is nothing but total blindness because cornea become soft, ulceration, and necrosis of cornea. Due to this reason, there is a total blindness. When xerophthalmia persists for a long time, it progresses to keratomalacia, causing total blindness. Then growth retardation in children. It also manifests growth retardation in children. There is a defective teeth formation in children. Skin becomes dry, scaly, and rough, pore-like skin, and keratinization leads to calculi formation. So this is about deficiency manifestation of vitamin A. Now this is about toxicity of vitamin A, which is also known as hypervitaminosis. Hypervitaminosis. So large dose of vitamin A is a toxin to the body. And sign and symptoms of this hypervitaminosis are as follows. First is headache, next is double vision, liver and bone damage, hair loss, weakness, nausea, vomiting, hypertension. Luckily or fortunately, all these symptoms would disappear within a week after you stop excess intake of vitamin A. So this is about toxicity of vitamin A. So this is a question bank for vitamin A. Long answer question, that is LAQ. Write down all of you. Describe the chemistry, sources, daily requirement, biochemical functions, and deficiency manifestation of vitamin A. Long question of this question is frequently asked in university exam. And next is SAQ, that is Wald's visual cycle. Wald's visual cycle. Have you got this? Have you written or not? Okay, describe the chemistry, sources, daily requirement, biochemical functions, and deficiency manifestation of vitamin A. This is a long question, and short answer question is Wald's visual cycle. So you have to take care about these two questions. Next is MCQs. These are the most important MCQs related to this vitamin A. First is, which of the following molecule is considered as vitamin A? Option is retinal, retinic acid, and D is all the above. Which one is correct answer?
All of the above.
Right. Is, which of the following forms of vitamin A acts as an antioxidant? Retinal, beta-carotene, and all the above. Which one is the answer?
Beta-carotene.
All the above. So, you got it or not? Okay, next is vitamin A is stored in the option is retina, B is liver, C is kidney, and D is bone. Which one is correct answer?
Liver.
And next is ocular manifestations in vitamin A deficiency is keratomalacia. B is night blindness, C is xerophthalmia, and D is all the above. Which one is correct?
All the above.
Very good. Okay. So these are the most important MCQ, which is frequently going to ask in an annual exam. Okay. So this is about vitamin A. Next is vitamin A. I think the vitamin D, you have finished? Dr. Bhargava Sahab have taken.
Yes,
Can I continue or not about this vitamin D?
Continue, sir.
Okay, thank you. Vitamin D, this is very, very important vitamin. This vitamin D is also known as sunshine vitamin. Which vitamin? Vitamin D is also known as sunshine, because the cheapest source of vitamin D is a sunlight. That's why it is known as vitamin sunshine, sunshine vitamin. So these are the objectives. At the end of again today's lecture, you should be able to understand chemistry of vitamin, sources, the requirement, then absorption, transport, storage, functions of vitamin D. And very important point is that vitamin D is a hormone. You have to give the justification. And deficiency manifestation of vitamin D. And lastly, vitamin D toxicity. So first, we are going to discuss about chemistry of vitamin D. So this vitamin D is also known as cholecalciferol. Another name for vitamin D is cholecalciferol. And vitamin D plays important role as a hormone. Vitamin D plays important role as a hormone, and it is also regulate calcium and phosphorus metabolism. Calcium and phosphorus metabolism. And if vitamin D, initially I told you the cheapest source of vitamin D is sunlight. And that's why it is produced by UV irradiation of the skin. Okay. So this vitamin D is also known as calciferol. Why it is known as calciferol? Because of its role in calcium metabolism. That's why it is known as calciferol. So another name for this vitamin D is anti-rachitic factor. Anti-rachitic factor. What is known as anti-rachitic factor? Because it prevents rickets. That's why it is known as anti-rachitic factor. So here there are two active form of vitamin D. First is ergocalciferol. Ergocalciferol, this is also known as vitamin D2. Ergocalciferol is also known as vitamin D2, and it is formed from ergosterol. It is formed from ergosterol, and this ergosterol is present in plant. Second is cholecalciferol. It is also known as vitamin D3, and it is found in animal as 7-dehydrocholesterol. You follow this? Ergocalciferol and cholecalciferol formed from ergosterol, which is present in plant, and cholecalciferol, it is found in an animal as a 7-dehydrocholesterol. It is a group of steroid compound. All these, always two, ergocalciferol and cholecalciferol, they contain cyclopentanoperhydrophenanthate D. Cyclopentanoperhydrophenanthate, hydroxyl group at carbon number 3, hydrocarbon side chain at carbon number 17. It also contains two conjugated double bond between carbon number 5 and carbon number 6, and carbon number 7 and carbon number 8. It is a white powder compound and heat stable. So this is about chemistry. Then next point is sources. Again, fish liver oil is the richest source of vitamin D. It is also present in egg yolk, butter, cheese, lard, margarine. These are the good sources of vitamin D. What is meant by lard? What is meant by margarine? Lard is a fat of pig, which is obtained from pig, and margarine, artificial butter. It is also present in milk, but milk is a poor source and cheapest source जो फोकट में मिलता है सबको that is sunlight. Sunlight is a cheapest source of vitamin D. So these are the sources. Then daily requirement for infant, children, pregnant and lactating woman requirement is 10 microgram per day. 10 microgram per day or 400 international unit per day. So this is for the requirement for infant, children, pregnant and lactating woman. Then for adult, requirement is less and it is 5 microgram, or you can say 200 international unit per day. But for senior citizen, old people whose age is above 60 years, requirement is more, that is 600 international unit per day. So this is a daily requirement of vitamin D. Then absorption, transport and storage of vitamin D. Vitamin D absorbed from small intestine along with bile salt. Bile salt is required for the absorption. Okay. After absorption, it is carried in chylomicrons droplet of the lymph in combination with a serum globulin in blood plasma. Okay. Then it is transported to liver. So here you have to remember one thing. In liver and in kidney, this vitamin D is synthesized first in liver in the form of calcitriol and in kidney in the form of calcitriol. So biologically active form of vitamin D is called as calcitriol. So this calcitriol, you have to remember this word. This is an active form of vitamin D, which is synthesized in liver and kidney. In liver, in the temporary form. The name of that form is calcidiol. But in kidney, in an active form, that is calcitriol. So biologically active form of vitamin D is called as calcitriol, synthesized in liver and kidney. Now, under skin, cholesterol is there. Now this cholesterol is converted into 7-dehydrocholesterol. Okay. When sunlight falls on the skin, this 7-dehydrocholesterol is converted into cholecalciferol. Okay. This is known as vitamin D3. And this cholecalciferol undergoes hydroxylation at 25th position in liver by the enzyme 25-hydroxylase to form 25-hydroxycholecalciferol. 25-hydroxyD3 means cholecalciferol. Of this 25-hydroxyD3, it is also known as calcitriol. So this is a temporary storage form of this vitamin D. It is synthesized in liver. This 25-hydroxycholecalciferol again undergoes hydroxylation at first position in kidney. First position in kidney, and by the help of which enzyme? 1-alpha-hydroxylase to form 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol. So this is known as calcitriol. So this calcitriol is a active form of vitamin D, and in this way this calcitriol is synthesized in liver and kidney, and this calcitriol is also known as active form of this vitamin D. So in this way calcitriol is synthesized and it is transported to the, it is formed into the kidney. Next is functions of vitamin D. Vitamin D also plays many important role in our body. Out of these are the few. First is, it is required for the regulation of blood calcium. It is also required for calcification of bone and also required for the cell growth differentiation. And one thing you have to remember here again, vitamin D acts on a target organ. It acts on a target organ like bone, kidney, and intestinal mucosa to regulate calcium and phosphate metabolism. So this is the most important functions of vitamin D: regulation of blood calcium, calcification of bone, cell growth differentiation, and this vitamin D acts on a target organ like bones, kidney, and intestinal mucosa to regulate calcium and phosphate metabolism. So these are the most important functions. Next is vitamin D is a hormone. You have to give the justification. So many times, short note may be asked on this topic. Vitamin D is a hormone, and you have to justify why it is a hormone. So these are following characteristics are there which justify vitamin D is a hormone. Okay, it is a justify its status as a hormone. First, it is synthesized in the skin. Initially, I told you when it is synthesized, it is also synthesized in skin. It is also synthesized in liver. It is also synthesized in kidney. So these are the most important organ where it is synthesized. It is synthesized first in skin by UV rays of sunlight. This is the first clarification, first feature, important feature. Next is calcitriol is produced in the kidney. Calcitriol is active form of vitamin D. It is produced in the kidney. And initially I told you it has target organs, intestine, bone, and kidney. And action of calcitriol is similar to steroid hormone. Action of this vitamin D is similar to steroid hormone. And one more important thing is that calcitriol synthesis is self-regulated. It is self-regulated by feedback mechanism. That is, it decreases its own synthesis. Okay, so these are the few characteristics are there of vitamin D which justify status of vitamin D as a hormone. Next is deficiency of vitamin D. You know, prolonged deficiency of vitamin D deficiency disease are rickets in children, osteomalacia in adult, and osteoporosis in old people. So one by one we are going to discuss here again. First is rickets. This word rickets, it is derived from England, England word rickan means twist. Rickan means twist, and it occur in children of low income group, in poor people whose dietary intake is very low. Okay, due to this reason, there is insufficient mineralization of bone, and insufficient mineralization of bone is there. Bone becomes soft and pliable. It becomes soft and pliable, and this pliable bone leads to deformities in skull, chest, spine, legs, and pelvis. Then next is osteomalacia. Osteo means bone. Malakia means softness. Osteo means bone, and malakia, softness. And it occur in only adult. It is also seen in pregnant women and women in parda. Women in parda means well, those who are very well or burkha. So it is seen in pregnant women and women in parda. And early sign is skeletal pain. Severe skeletal pain is there, and deformities of ribs, spine, pelvis, and legs. So this is about osteomalacia. Next is osteoporosis. Osteoporosis, it occur in old people. Old people means whose age is above 60, is in senior citizen. In this, there is a decreased photolysis of provitamin. In old age, there is a decrease of photolysis of provitamin and also decreased production of sex hormone. For this reason, vitamin D is very less. And symptoms are bone pain, bone become porous. Porous means chote chote, also bone, surround the porous bones. And if porous bone is there, bone fractures are most common in this osteoporosis. Next is toxicity of vitamin D. If you take high dose above 1500 per day for long time, symptoms are weakness, intense thirst, polyuria, difficulty in speaking, and weight loss, and hypercalcemia, hypokalemia, metabolic alkalosis, and one more silent finding is there, that is calcification of soft tissue. So this is a toxicity of vitamin D. So this is again question bank for this vitamin D. LAQ, out of these two questions, vitamin A or vitamin B or vitamin C? Long question may be asked on this three. Vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin C. So first question is, describe the chemistry, sources, the requirement, chemical functions of deficiency manifestation of vitamin D. And SAQ, vitamin D is a hormone, we have to justify. That is rickets and osteomalacia. Okay, so this is about LAQ and SAQ. MCQs. First important MCQ is the active form of vitamin D is, the option is 120. Hello?
A option.
Why it is? Because it is 125 hydroxycholine calciferol. This is the active form of vitamin D. And what is another name for this?
Calcitriol.
Calcitriol. Second MCQ is the
all
of the above.
थर्ड इज विटामिन डी कंसिडर हार्मोन बिकॉज इसका भी क्या है ऑल द अबव वेरी नाइस लास्ट क्या है Thank you for watching. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
चलो बहुत दिन के बाद हमें चांस मिला साहब ने दिया है तो आज शाम के सामने हाजिर हो गए हम शायद तो बोलो This type of lecture I don't like. Do you like this or not?
No, sir.
क्या होना फिर आपको कौन सा लेक्चर होना
सर जेनेटिक्स थोड़ा ये कर रहा हूं हां जेनेटिक्स जेनेटिक्स
जेनेटिक्स पढ़ाओ
हां सर
सर
अच्छा जेनेटिक्स में कौन सा कौन जेनेटिक्स